Omicron, a new COVID-19 variant with an extremely high number of mutations, was reported to the World Health Organization by South Africa on November 24th, and it was soon designated a variant of concern. It took around 2 months for Delta to be labeled as a VOC, but with Omicron, the classification came within 72 hours. Why have so many countries slammed their borders shut? Is Omicron really so much worse than other variants? How exactly is it different? Omicron is a fast-spreading variant. In South Africa, about 75% of the cases in the country are now caused by Omicron. To understand why Omicron is different, we need to look at something called spike protein. The SARS-CoV-2 spike protein is a crucial part of the virus that binds host ACE2, a protein on the surface of human cells for virus entry. It's also crucial for our immune system to recognize the virus and is the main target for the development of COVID vaccines and neutralizing antibody therapy. In simple terms, this is pretty much like archery. When the shape of the archer's target changes too much, it's a little bit more challenging to get a perfect bullseye. Now, the Delta variant contains 16 changes on the spike protein, whereas that number for Omicron is about 32 or more. Scientists say it's still unclear if Omicron is more transmissible or has a higher risk of severe infection. But researchers have shown that if the spike protein contains mutation K417N, E484A, or N501Y, it's a prompt message to say that the variant could evade immune protection. And Omicron contains all three of them.
The profile of the mutation strongly suggests that it's going to have an advantage in transmissibility and that it might evade immune protection that you would get, for example, from a monoclonal antibody or from the convalescent serum after a person's been infected, and possibly even against some of the vaccine-induced antibodies.
According to GSAID, one of the conjectural reasons for the appearance of Omicron is being immunocompromised, as scientists say such people can harbor the coronavirus for longer, which results in a higher potential of evolving and larger amounts of mutations. A report on Medrics showed a case of a COVID patient with HIV where the virus mutated 32 times in the body, 13 of which happened on the spike protein. When other viruses, such as the SARS-CoV-2 virus, get into cells of a HIV-positive body, the virus cannot be recognized, eliminated, or destroyed by the immune system. So the virus keeps replicating and mutating with the human body as a receptor, because that's what viruses do to survive. The US CDC says people with HIV may be more likely to become severely ill from COVID-19. And many scientists believe that the appearances of new COVID variants may be linked with a high prevalence of AIDS in some areas, but more time, evidence, and investigation are needed. Omicron is a painful reminder for the world that this pandemic is far from over. And this time, it seems that our enemy is shooting with more firepower. So, are we doomed? Questions regarding the effectiveness of current testing kits have been raised. But officials from major test makers and disease control organizations, including the Chinese CDC, have said that the genome analysis of Omicron indicates that testing kits in place still provide accurate results and are able to detect SARS-CoV-2 in samples containing Omicron, as its mutation site doesn't affect the sensitivity and specificity of the nucleic acid detection reagents. It's not necessarily a bad thing that new variants of novel coronavirus keep showing up. This gives us a chance to better understand the virus from more perspectives, which will eventually help the development of treatments. And no matter if it's Beta, Delta, or Omicron, we need to keep doing what we have become more than familiar with: control source of infection, cut off transmission methods, and protect vulnerable groups. Scientists around the world are racing to research and crack Omicron's code. Meanwhile, for us, the best weapon is always protecting ourselves to protect others. That's it for today. I'm Ning. I'll see you next time.